ExactVision can be configured to send email notifications to one or more people when triggered by various events. Navigate to the Notification Settings page by going to the Configuration screen and selecting Notifications from the Configuration tree on the left-hand side. The first step in configuring notifications is to set up a connection to an outgoing mail server to send messages. Select the Email Server tab and click the New button at the bottom left of the page to create a new email server configuration. You will now complete the configuration in the panel on the right. Give the configuration a descriptive name. Next, enter the address of the email server. This may be an IP address or a domain name. For example, the hostname for Gmail is smtp.gmail.com. If you aren't sure what the proper SMTP values are and your organization uses a private email server, consult your system administrator. If you are using a hosted email provider such as Gmail or Yahoo, you may need to consult their documentation or contact their support team for details. The port number defaults to 25. Using the security drop-down menu allows you to select the security protocol used by your provider. Email servers using SSL security often use port 465. Port 587 is also commonly used for TLS encryption. Again, if you aren't sure which port to use, contact your administrator or email provider's documentation. If your outgoing email server requires authentication, complete the username and password fields. Finally, click Add to save your email server configuration. You may add more than one email server configuration. When a notification must be sent, ExactVision will try the first email server in the list. If that attempt should not succeed, the system will continue with the next email server in the list until the email is successfully sent. You may adjust the order of the email servers in the list using the up and down arrow buttons beside the window. With the outgoing mail server configured, you can now configure the email message to send. Select the Email Message Profiles tab and create a new email message profile using the New button at the lower left, enabling the panel on the right. Give the profile a descriptive name that you can recognize later when configuring the event that will send this message. The When drop-down menu allows you to select the point of an event when the action triggers. Selecting Alarm Starts sends a notification at the beginning of an event. Alarm Ends sends at the end of the event. By selecting Alarm Starts and Ends, two notifications will be sent, one at both the beginning and the end of the event. The Send Rate Limit setting ensures that ExactVision does not send the same message too often, thereby flooding your inbox. Some events that can trigger notifications can happen frequently within a short time frame, generating dozens or hundreds of emails. When the send rate limit is set to a value higher than zero, ExactVision will send a message only once within the specified time period. Setting the limit to 600 seconds would restrict ExactVision to sending one message every 10 minutes. The From address will be who the recipient receives the message from, and is also where any reply to messages are sent. The recipient list can contain one or more addresses as primary recipients, carbon copy recipients, or blind carbon copy recipients. If some recipients prefer to receive text messages on mobile phones, you may be able to specify their phone number as an email address depending on their carrier. For example, T-Mobile customers can receive text messages by specifying their 10-digit phone number at tmomail.net. Note that some carriers may not show the subject line and content must be 140 characters or less. Consult your carrier for further details. The remaining fields describe the content of the notification message. The subject and message fields support substitution variables that will automatically be replaced with the actual value at the time the message is sent. For example, if creating a notification that triggers when a camera loses connection to the server, it is useful to see the specific camera in the message. First, click on the Subject Input box. This enables the Add Field drop-down selector. Click on the field Source in the drop-down. This adds the variable source to the subject text. You may also add additional text to the subject. In this example, we will create a subject line that states what event has occurred and what device is affected. the source field will be substituted with the name of the camera. You may also type the substitution variable directly. Each field may occur once in the subject and body. Once an email message profile is created, you can test the notification using the Test Profile button. These steps have defined how to send a message and what the message should contain. The last step is to define when to send a message. This requires event linking configuration. Event linking is covered in detail in a separate event linking video. Lastly, email notifications also allow you to include a direct link to a video associated with the event. To provide this link, select the Web Server tab from the top of the page. You must enter an IP address or domain name of your ExactVision web server and click Apply. Including this direct link is as simple as using the web link substitution variable in your email message. The final tab on this page, Webhooks, allow you to notify external services providing webhook endpoints when certain events occur. This will be covered in detail in a separate video.